video, I'm going to show you how to change the sensor fan. First of all, you have to remove this cartridge at the back here. Then there's two screws at the back. One screw, two screws at the back here. Remove it. You need a long screw driver. After that, at the bottom here, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 screws. So if you remove them, once you're done, you lay down, you open up the casing. So, and then you remove this 4-wire 1, 2, 3, 4. So, in the manual, it says black or white. So, sometimes, depends on your model, it's maybe blue and brown. But make sure this is the AC in, and this is the DC out is always the same, black and red. Alright, and then you remove the screw that mount on the motherboard. So there should be three or four screws that lock the motherboard on the tray. So you remove this three screws. Okay, once it's done, it's easier to find a screwdriver with magnets. Right, once it's done, you take this out and put this aside. Put this aside. This is the thing. Take out this. And then you remove this. Check it out. Okay. So once the tray is out, there's two screws that lock it. Two screws. A long screw. So when these two screws, long screw is done, stand it up, and then you can remove the back cover. So the rest you don't have to remove anymore. You just slightly turn this aside, so to export the bottom. You see the small little cap here. All right, then you turn it. You open up. There are three smaller screws. You have to take out the O-ring, and you use a magnet to. Well, this is the fan. This is the old fan. Then you replace it with a new one. Okay, put in the new one. Put it in the middle. So, all right, it's done. The fan is done, and then you cover it back. It's fast and easy. Okay, make sure the O-ring is firm, and then you screw it back. Screw it back. Mix around. Screw it back. The smaller screw. Get three screws. you don't have to do as fast as me because I'm so used to it. Make sure you don't mix around with the screw. It's better to arrange the screw accordingly so you won't mix up the screw. It's easier that way. And then you screw it back. And then you reverse the process. Okay. I might as well record it. Right. I assemble it. Right. Okay. When it's done, you put this cover back. Make sure the head in first. Okay. Head in first. This one right position. Lay down. So make sure it doesn't clip on the wire. The hole doesn't lock on the wire. So this one at the back. Remember the AC. This is the direct. It's at the top here. And the DC out is this one. This one. Is, yeah. So you position here, right? Then you screw it back. This screw. This long screw. Should be two to lock the electrolysis chamber from to the back cover. So when it's done, and put this thing back into place. So then you screw it back. Screw it back, three screw here. Cover this back. And then pull the thing. Motherboard in. Screw it firm in place. So it's like they put the cover on the side like this. You don't have to remove this. Well, if it's inconvenient for you, you can remove it, but you just better leave it that way. Okay, then just pre-screw. Okay, then you plug it back. This one, make sure this is AC. This one always, this corner is always black and red. Okay, and then the speed sensor fan is on the, it's written speed there. Okay, then cover it back. Always the top in first, you see? The top in first. And make sure the wire doesn't come out. Then you screw it back the 6th screw. It's done. Alright? Good luck.